Hi there, thanks for joining. This is Duncan from koasoundphotography.com. Today we're having a look at the Sigma 50mm f1.4 DG. This is referred to as the art lens. So already picking the box up, you can feel there's some weight inside there as well. What I like about the box though, it's actually nicely understated really. I think they've probably gone for a very contemporary sort of basic look to the box, but I think that kind of adds to it really. So I've read a lot about the Sigma 50mm f1.4. It's been extremely well received by the press, and I'm really excited about using it. I've pretty much shot most of my work on prime lenses. Started off using, of course, the 50mm Canon 1.8, very cheap, plasticky. I'm using my Canon 1.4 to film today, using my Canon 5D Mark III. So this lens should be a fantastic match for the 5D Mark III. What we will do though is put it onto the Canon Mark I that I've got here, just so we can have a look at how it looks, and maybe just run through one or two of the features really. But I think probably the best thing I can do now is get on with unboxing it really. So the material of the box seems pretty substantial, quite like that. So let's have a look inside. Okay, so as we open the box, I can see there's some booklets in there. So I think this is probably the warranty. Yep. So Sigma's limited European, or it says European limited warranty. I wonder if I have to fill that out or possibly fill it out online. Something to come back to later anyway. And here, the 50mm f1.4 DG HSM art lens. I'm assuming this is the instruction manual. Yeah, we've got it in English, but I think it's in multiple languages as well. Nice paper, good quality. Here I've got, what have I got here? Oh, this is the warranty sticker. So it says here, please stick the warranty sticker to the dedicated warranty sticker column on the other sheet of the limited warranty. So I suspect I've got to do something with this and possibly this, but I'll check that after the video. Right, so in here we've got the Sigma lens. It's got its own case. So let's just gently pull that out and see what we've got. Yeah, okay, so I'll just put this out of the way for now. The material they've used in here seems very nice. I mean, that really feels quite padded. There's a fair bit of weight in the lens as well. There's two zips there. Let's just unzip it and see what we've got inside. Okay, so it looks like there's high compact foam maybe, but obviously that's designed to just keep things nice and snug in the case. As I open it there, oh wow, that does feel quite heavy. Very nice. There's the lens, and I'm looking, this is the lens HUD. So what we'll do is, let's have a look at the lens first of all. Take it out of its plastic bag. Ooh, wow, that feels fantastic. Really, really nice. Gosh, that's just lovely. That's got a sort of a matte finish there. And this focus ring feels very big, very sturdy feeling lens. And just on the side, as you would expect with a lot of these lenses, it's got the AF, MF focus, so it's easy enough just to switch between the two. I'm assuming the little A there is the, well, of course, that'll be the insignia for the art lens. And wow, I can't believe how great that feels. That's just lovely. Let's just have a look at the front of it first of all. You can see you've got the Sigma lens cover. It's got quite a nice feel to it, almost feels almost like it's like suede maybe. I know I'm probably not using the right sort of language there, but that does feel lovely. It's got two very substantial sort of tabs there, so let's just pull that out. Oh wow, that's lovely. Yeah, okay, so we've got a huge element there, look. Probably not sure if I can show it off all that well under these lights, really, but yeah, looks great. That's the back of the lens there. Glass looks incredible on it, really lovely. I mean, I'm absolutely delighted with this. I think this looks just fantastic. There's a nice sort of polished feel right there. That is incredibly well finished, just there as well. Yeah, and these feel sort of metallic. There's a nice grip just on the bottom half of the lens as well, which is lovely. And then, of course, you've got the section there for the lens hood to go on. So let's take the lens hood out of the bag, give that a look. Yeah, okay, so this is obviously just plastic, but it doesn't feel particularly cheap. I would say that's actually a beautiful finish on that. And looking at that, we just go in or out. It says on the side here, so if I just sort of click it in. Oh, there you go. Oh, very solid sort of click to it just there. And that's the lens with the lens hood. The big front element as well, I haven't got the UV filter for that, so I'll probably put that on later. But I think what we should do now is just have a look at this on the camera itself. I'll just move this to one side. Let's get the... So I'm using my Mark 1 just to demo the lens today. So let's just have a quick look. So you can see that there's the red and the white dot there, so just line that up and click that in. Yeah, very secure fix there. That is a fantastic looking lens. Gosh, I'm absolutely delighted with that. I think that's superb. Now, I don't even know if you can pick that up. I've got a mic with me. And that is a very, very quiet motor. In fact, it's pretty much silent. There you go, and it's focused on something there. That is wonderful looking. Very, very pleased with that. When you compare that to the first Canon 50mm in the range, the 1.8, I mean, it's obviously not even a patch on quality, really. The 1.4 that I'm using, though, even just to film today, is a great lens. It is my sort of standard lens. But I've got to be honest, I'm much more comfortable with prime lenses. I just like the simplicity, but also the quality of the pictures as well. I have got another video on where I've unboxed the Canon EF 24-70mm, the f2.8. That's really my first proper zoom lens of that sort of quality. But believe me, when you take pictures with prime lenses, you just can't believe the quality you can get. So I'm really excited about having this lens. I'm excited about taking some photographs with it as well. So if you do have any questions or comments, I'd love to hear from you guys. Certainly let me know what you think to this video. And if you contact me as well, as I'm getting more and more used to the lens, of course I'll post some responses to it as well. But that is stunning. That is a stunning, stunning lens. Very, very pleased to have that in my bag. Yeah. So I'm assuming that can just go that way just for while it's in the kit bag. Yep, that goes in beautifully. Let's just put the lens cap on. Fantastic. I've also bought, I've just put it up on the table, I've not opened it yet, but I've also got the docking station for the lens as well. This is the USB dock UD01. I haven't actually opened this box yet, but you can see the style of the box is the same as the lens. Let's just open it. Okay, so it's got the same sort of things. It's got the warranty, instruction manuals, etc. There's a lovely little base unit there. So I'm assuming this logged into the laptop in some way. And then I figure there must be some way of connecting the two up. So I don't know how to do that just yet, but I'm sure in due course I'll be able to figure that out. Oh, I see. Okay, so it's got a unit there, a bit like the base cap on your lens. And then looking at this, I suspect you take this off, line up the two dots on there, and then click it into position. And then I suspect you put that into the USB and it updates all the firmware on the lens. So a bit of a learning curve for me with this Sigma Art lens, but of course its simplicity is what's what you're buying into when you get a prime lens. So really looking forward to getting to work with this one, and I really look forward to getting your comments on it as well. So get in touch. If you're getting in touch via the website, that'll be great. If you just drop me a note on YouTube, I'll respond to them really within a couple of days. So thanks for watching. Hopefully you found this unboxing useful. And if you've got any questions about the lens, get in touch and I'll be more than happy to respond in due course. So that's it. Again, I'm Duncan from coasoundphotography.com and look forward to you joining me on another video soon. Bye for now.